ది మోర్ యు క్యూర్ ఆన్ ది ఫిజికల్ ప్లేన్ ది మోర్ విల్ బి ది ఇంటెన్సిటీ ఆఫ్ ది డిసీజ్ ఆన్ ది ప్లేన్ ఆఫ్ ఫోర్సెస్ అండ్ ఇంటెలిజెన్సెస్ దేర్ ఫార్ ది కాజెస్ ఆఫ్ హెల్త్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఇన్ ది కాన్షియస్నెస్ అండ్ ది ఫోర్సెస్ అండ్ ది రిజల్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ హెల్త్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఆర్ ఎంజాయిడ్ ఆన్ ది ఫిజికల్ బాడీ సిమిలర్లీ ది కాజెస్ ఆఫ్ డిసీజ్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఆన్ ది మెంటల్ అండ్ ది వైటల్ ప్లేన్స్ అండ్ ది రిజల్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ డిసీజ్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్డ్ ఆన్ ది ఫిజికల్ ప్లేన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది యూజ్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ హంటింగ్ ది ఫిజికల్ టిష్యూస్ టు ఫైండ్ ది కాజ్ ఆఫ్ ది డిసీజ్ సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ది న్యూ డైమెన్షన్ దట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ బై ది హోమియోపతిక్ థాట్ అండ్ సిమిలర్లీ ది ఆర్ట్ ఆఫ్ హీలింగ్ గివ్స్ అస్ ది వేరియస్ మెథడ్స్ టు నో ది రీఅరేంజింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఇంటెలిజెన్సెస్ దట్ ఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఇన్ అవర్ బాడీ సిమిలర్లీ ది ఆర్ట్ ఆఫ్ హీలింగ్ గ్రాడ్యువలీ మేక్స్ అస్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ది వేరియస్ ఇంటెలిజెన్సెస్ దట్ ఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఇన్ అస్ అండ్ హౌ దే ఆర్ టు బి రీఅరేంజ్డ్ ప్రాపర్లీ సో దట్ దే మే ఇండ్యూస్ అవర్ కాన్షియస్ ఇంటెలిజెన్స్ నార్మలీ అండ్ మేక్ ఏ సెలెక్టివ్ వే ఆఫ్ లివింగ్ అండ్ రెండర్ ది ఫిజికల్ బాడీ హెల్దీ సో దీస్ ఆర్ ది రియల్ అడ్వాన్స్డ్ సైన్సెస్ దట్ ఆర్ టు కమ్ ఇన్ ది నెక్స్ట్ సెంచురీ అండ్ సిన్స్ మెనీ పీపుల్ ఇన్ దిస్ సెంచురీ ఆర్ నాట్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ టు రిసీవ్ దెమ్ దే మే లాఫ్ అట్ దెమ్ బట్ ది యూనివర్సిటీస్ ఆఫ్ ది నెక్స్ట్ సెంచురీ విల్ టీచ్ దీస్ సబ్జెక్ట్స్ యాజ్ ది రియల్ సైన్సెస్ అండ్ లెట్ అస్ మేక్ ఎ సింథటిక్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది త్రీ సబ్జెక్ట్స్ టుగెదర్ దట్ ఈస్ ది సబ్జెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ స్పిరిచువలిజం ది సబ్జెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ హీలింగ్ అండ్ ది సబ్జెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ హోమియోపతి అండ్ ఇన్ ది నెక్స్ట్ సెంచురీ ఎలోపతి ఈజ్ నాట్ కన్సిడర్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ సైన్స్ అట్ ఆల్ బికాస్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ నో సొల్యూషన్ ఫర్ సైకలాజికల్ అండ్ మెంటల్ డిసీజెస్ టిల్ టుడే ది ఓన్లీ సొల్యూషన్ దట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ ఈజ్ ది నార్కోటిక్స్ అండ్ ది డేంజరస్ డ్రగ్స్ దట్ ఆర్ అన్ఫార్చునేట్లీ ట్రాన్స్లేటెడ్ ఇన్ టు ట్రాంక్విలైజర్స్ అండ్ సెడేటివ్స్ వెనెవర్ ది ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఫైండ్స్ ఏ మెంటల్ ఆర్ ఎ నర్వస్ పేషెంట్ ఆర్ ఎన్ ఎపిలెప్టిక్ పేషెంట్ ఇమీడియట్లీ ది మోడర్న్ మెడికల్ సైంటిస్ట్ బిగిన్స్ టు పాయిజన్ హిమ్ విత్ దీస్ సెడేటివ్స్ అండ్ ట్రాంక్విలైజర్స్ సో దెర్ ఈస్ నో సొల్యూషన్ అబ్సల్యూట్లీ ఇన్ ది నోన్ మెడికల్ సైన్స్ ఫర్ ది మెంటల్ అండ్ నర్వస్ ట్రబుల్స్ అండ్ ది సైన్స్ ఆఫ్ అలోపతి స్టాప్స్ విత్ ది ఫిజికల్ బాడీ సో దెర్ ఈస్ నో మచ్ ఫ్యూచర్ ఇన్ ది నెక్స్ట్ సెంచురీ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ homeopathy and spiritual healing that take a prominent part in the light of the proper understanding of the polarities and temperaments on the background of the scientific astrology of course there is much superstitious about astrology and there is much unscientific about the astrologers but that does not prove anything against astrology just as the modern medicine is misused astrology is also misused sometimes just as an expert cannot save a patient sometimes astrologer also fails to predict sometimes but remember that astrology is not for prediction mainly for self analysis and self knowledge to know your strong points and weak points to know a selective way of your career to know what to do and what not to do to know when to do and when not to do with whom you have to do and with whom you have to you should not do it is for the self analysis and self realization that the true scientific astrology aims at in the light of this subject when homeopathy is properly used and healing is properly used and even homeopathy if it is used only when it is necessary then we will have ideal way of doing things. In our clinics in India, we many times give only sugar pills to many patients. If we find that they are to be healed without medicine, only if there is a deeper disturbance in the very tissues of the constitution, and only when it is too late, when a patient comes to us, then we use homeopathic medicine. Even without medicine, we find the results astounding and surprising. This is a statistical truth which no one can deny. And in all the 80 big clinics we are running in India, we preserve all the successfully cured, completed cases on records with their names and addresses, and also the details of how we cured them. With all this, we are only simple children and students when we understand the vastness of the subject of healing. Let us remember that we are children gathering pebbles on the shores of knowledge, and let us gather more valuable things in course of time. I only appeal to you to make a synthesis of the various subjects and find the oneness of the various subjects. And any questions are welcome, and I will try to answer. It is one of the advanced sciences, at the same time most ancient, and it also forms a part of real healing. But modern practitioners are still in infancy, and a systematic training and a systematic course is required before it can be successfully used. There are experts in acupuncture, but many imitators are also trying to do harm to many people, just as there are false astrologers and commercial doctors. But it is a very valuable dimension in the direction of healing, and it should be practiced, systematized, and made a course to be taught to students in a systematic way. Why? What is your doubt? Go through the scientific books on healing and you will know the answers already there. There are various types of spiritual beings who are illumined. Many of them receive the cumulative effect of the misdeeds of mankind, and they are ready to make the sacrifice. And that is the one cause of cancer among the great people. There are many great people who had cancer in their last days. But the truth is, some people, they take the cumulative bad karma of the mankind of the day. They don't care purchasing some betterment to mankind at the cost of one of their bodies, which they think very cheap, just as Lord Jesus thought that it was good for him to purchase the kingdom of God to all the mankind at the cost of one simple body. Cancer is due to such causes, for especially mystics and the enlightened ones. You can know much about this in the book Esoteric Healing by Alice A. Bailey. Now, the solution is to gather into groups and make new trainees in homeopathy in the light of spiritual sciences, instead of making long and tiring discussions with people who already know something. It is better to make a new beginning with new recruits when after a time the old recruits are also ready to receive. That gives much economy of labor and effort. In India, I have started in the same line. I have prepared the first group of servers from those who were around me and trained them as the first batch of homeopathic physicians, at the same time enlightening them into the world scriptures. Even today the classes run in such a direction that in each session of 2 months in the vacations, I conduct classes of scriptures in the morning and classes of homeopathy in the evening. And at the end of the 2 months, I issue a diploma to them so that they come and take part in one of the existing clinics for 1 year when they can begin to prescribe. Now, at the end of 15 years, I have prepared many hundreds of qualified physicians in homeopathy who are very well versed in the scriptures also and who know yoga and spiritualism. And the scientific, so-called scientific doctors of our place, they began to come to consult us now. First they consulted in secrecy and now they consult us openly. They bring their patients to our clinics and they feel it a joy to get them cured. And gradually there is coming a time when all the doctors are taking part in our group. Suppose I began with opposing the existing doctors, what would have been the future? It is only a wastage of time and energy. So same thing may be attained in Belgium also. We can start in the same direction, doing our lot of good work in our own way, forming groups, get ourselves trained in the homeopathy and spiritual, beginning to heal our own families. That is how we started, and that is how I believe everyone should start. We have in our clinics a systematic way of case taking. The form consists of not only the name and address of the patient, but also the date, time and place of birth. And in really chronic diseases, which take a very long time to cure, or which are already overdrugged for a very long time, we definitely make a horoscope, and by studying the natal horoscope and the progressed chart, we make an estimate of the possibility of curability and the mode of treatment to be used. And at every step, the horoscope is useful in such complicated cases, so that we may use every part of our healing knowledge. And the persons who live with the patient are also carefully decided. And to decide the diet and the daily habits of the patient, we use astrology when we find a case very much complicated. Now, some branches of astrology are applied in India, whereas the other branches remain there in the books, not applied. Similarly, some other branches are applied in the Chinese tradition, and a third method of application is done in the Occident. But basically, there are no fundamental differences in the science of astrology. The differences exist only in certain details. as far as ancient Indian astrology required for Ayurveda is concerned, is exactly the same as we do in the Occident now, except one branch which is not popular in the Occident. That is the knowledge of the fixed stars. The influence of certain fixed stars is there in Indian astrology, which is to be supplemented to the modern Occidental astrology. But for this, there is no actual difference in the basic astrological procedures of ancient India and modern Occident. If we make a comparative study of the astrology of ancient India, modern Occident and China, and make a study of the common base of the three branches, you will find it is exactly identical. See, the astrology of the fixed stars is much vaster than any branch of astrology known today in any country. Even in India, it is not popular nowadays, but there are people who have studied it, and you can know something about it in the book Esoteric Astrology of Alice A. Bailey, my book Spiritual Astrology. The basis of the astrology of the stars is like this. Each star we see is a solar system in its own turn, and each solar system is in its own plane of evolution comparatively. There are some solar systems far much evolved than our solar system in which we live, and these are called the sacred stars in the scriptures. You find the same sanctity given to the stars in the scriptures of all ancient nations. And especially in the ancient Indian astrology, you will find the signs of the tortoise. That is, starting from above the pole star, taking it as the tail of the tortoise, coming down to the seven stars of the bear, taking them as the hind portion of the tortoise. Like that, there is the location of all the stars that are visible to our solar system, dividing the various zones into the various limbs of the tortoise. And for example, the sun of our present solar system in the right shoulder of the tortoise, and then each star is given its own study differently, and its own significance is given differently. When the important degrees of a horoscope fall on any one of these stars, you will find the birth of the great peacemakers and the great prophets of the world, and how the wrong degrees coincide with one of these stars at birth, cause diseases like cancer and incurable diseases, and how blindness and other things are caused due to our wrong routine. When the important degrees fall upon certain fixed stars. So, a combined study of these stars by the various nations in the modern age makes us understand the common secrets of the ancient astrologers, and how they are used in medical astrology we will come to know. He need not live according to his horoscope, because instinctively he lives according to his horoscope, because he does what is to be done he does not do what is not to be. So he need not verify his living according to his horoscope, and his horoscope only shows his way of living, because he never transgresses the law. Only one technique which I have given in an independent lecture, and today's lecture included three different subjects, so I could not go into the detail of it. At all there is any possibility for the madam to meet me, I can explain her how I do it. It is said in the science of karma that the past karma was done by us, and the good karma can be done by us. The good karma we do neutralizes the past karma we have done, provided if it is not too late. It is like cooking. The same fire can be used to burn a house or to cook our food. When we have an eye upon the contents of the cooking food, while it is being cooked, nothing can be too late. When we know our duties for today, and when we know our weaknesses of yesterday, we can make good of our weaknesses by making an offering of what we have to do more than what we are expected to do. So the results of karma are contrived by ourselves. In the same way we can do it at the present also, to neutralize the results of the past karma. Provided the results of the past karma are not yet achieved, anything is possible. If the past karma has reached a stage of its results in the present, nothing can be done against it except enduring. We can take care of some karma whose results have not yet been stimulated in the present. That is what the karma theory says. The patient need not have much spirituality, because if at all he has sufficient degree of spirituality, he cannot be called a patient. So there is no use of our dictating terms for the suffering mankind. It is the healer who has to qualify himself, and it is his merit and excellency that makes a patient not only a healthy man, but also a healer in his own turn. Each question at a time, madam. Please repeat the first question, I'll tell you. It is known by the results. How can you know if your doctor is a quack or a real doctor? Only by experience. Yes, there are methods which can be skillfully applied to know our planets, even though we do not know our date and time of our. There are positive and definite methods to know. Now, it is a subject in itself, independent, and it requires at least one full discourse. So this is, I don't think this is the proper time. Yugas, yes.
You mentioned the yugas.
Yes. There is no escape from the bigger cycles, for the simple fact that we too form a part of the creation of this earth. Just as the geological changes cannot escape themselves in this earth, just as the fauna and flora of this earth cannot escape their own way of creation, just as the animals cannot escape from their own nature, so also the human being is too little on this earth to escape from his own human nature. however intellectual the human being may be. You see how the dog cannot be a cow, and a cow cannot be a human being. Similarly, the human being cannot be anything else except only a human being. And he is only subservient to the laws that are geological and geographical. And the changes that take place in the vast sweeps of the ages given in the scriptures, they create changes upon the continents and the living